Hey there, fellow AI enthusiasts. Today we're generating SDXL images with Invoke AI in Google Collab. If you're looking for an introduction to Invoke AI or a quick local installation guide, we have one in our previous video, SDXL and Invoke AI Quickstart. All right, no time to waste. The link to the notebook is conveniently placed in the description and pinned comment below. So let's get started. All you need is a Google account. However, if you'd like some extra space in your notebook, ensure you've got about 7 GB free on Google Drive. That way you can even try some additional models. If you're just here for the base SDXL model or using 16-bit precision, storage won't be a concern. It's wise to duplicate the notebook. This lets you experiment without any worries. We're using the notebook that downloads the latest release. In case you have a specific version in mind, you can edit the line here that downloads the app and change to, say, release 302 to work with that one. We'll just go with the latest release. Storing the bulky SDXL base model is a breeze with Google Drive. If you're trying this out for the first time, consider using a CPU runtime. This ensures smooth saving to Drive and will save precious GPU time. This is not required. If resources are no concern, you can run the whole script on GPU. To install Invoke AI and the needed libraries, click the play button next to the first code block. If you want to use Google Drive to save the base model, make sure the checkmark to use Drive is set. Otherwise, space will get a bit cramped, but the base and refiner models should still fit on disk. Your SDXL folder's name? Totally up to you. A quick tip. If there's an incomplete download in that folder, wipe it clean. Let the script handle the fresh installation for you. The next step is where we set up the base configuration, and after that we can install the SDXL model. So, in the first run, we're on CPU and we're just running the first three steps. When the third one is complete, you'll see the SDXL model stored in Google Drive. Now switch and repeat. Let's transition to the GPU runtime and rerun. We get less disk space in this one, but when it comes to generating images, we want that GPU juice. The third step will now only take a second. Fancy some finesse to your images. Step 4 lets you download the refiner. Since it's optional, I'll show a quick run without it first. I won't skip the step 5, which links the image output folder and database to Drive, because I want to be able to access my images after disconnecting the notebook. This will also let me view the gallery from this run in the future. Step 6 is for adding other SDXL models. I don't use it on the free tier, so I'll skip this one too. This step can also be done directly from the web UI. Now we're ready to run the app. We have two options, ngrok, which only works with versions 3.0.2 and later, and local tunnel, which also works with 3.0.0 and 3.0.1. I'll go with local tunnel. Hit the local tunnel link and paste the IP in the endpoint IP field. For versions 3.0.0 and 3.0.1, a tiny tweak is needed. To make the app work, simply go to the address bar, remove the S from HTTPS, and press enter to reload the page. This trick will only work with local tunnel. With the app started, let's create a simple image. You can switch back to the notebook tab to see the models getting loaded into memory. It took about 4 minutes in this run. Let me know in the comments if you guys are having better luck with hands. I'll go ahead and add the refiner to see what it does to the result. Back in step 4, we can download and install the refiner. Now all we have to do is start the app again and fill in the refiner fields. The image turned out different. Let's try some more. Okay, that one looks better. I wonder, what would these images look like with a different model? Without running into memory issues, we can install models from Hugging Face as long as they're available in the diffusers format. Let's go grab one. I'll get DreamShaper first. The links to these will be added to the video description. Once installed, the model will be added to the models.yaml file. We'll need this later. it can be a good idea to stop the app between model installs and restart the runtime to free up RAM. Restarting will not delete anything on the disk, just free up memory. With the model happily waiting to generate beautiful images, let's reuse parameters from our last image, but select DreamShaper this time. I'll go grab a coffee while the image slowly takes shape. Before checking out a new model, I want to free up some space, so I'll move DreamShaper to Google Drive for later use. The folder can be simply dragged and dropped to Drive. To avoid any app errors, I'll open the model's config file and manually remove the model I just moved away to Drive. Let's start the app again and try another one. Just because the last model is on Drive doesn't mean we can't still use it. Simply go to the Import Models tab, copy the model's new location, and paste it into the location field. Voila! The model is ready to use again. But we also want to add a new one. How about Animagine? This one is in anime style. I want to see what it does to the lizard. Same as last time, we paste the model identifier and wait for the installation to finish. While the model is being downloaded, we can keep an eye on disk usage in the notebook. When it's ready, we can see all our models on the list. So how about that lizard? I like them all. Which one do you think turned out best? Maybe the difference will be more apparent on one of the fairies. I like how her wings are symmetrical in this one. Before checking out the Pro tier on Collab, let's quickly have a look at another cloud alternative for running Invoke. Kaggle. There's a tiny prerequisite for this one. You'll need to verify your Kaggle account with a phone number. This ensures our notebook has internet access and can leverage the power of a GPU. With the account created, I'll open the notebook and make sure the GPU is connected before the test run. With that done, we can simply start running the cells marked required. Starting with installing dependencies and invoke onto configuration, getting the base and refiner model, making sure the images are persistent, and finally running the app. In the test run with the base model and refiner, everything worked as expected. Want to ensure your work stays put for your next Kaggle notebook adventure? Opt for the files-only persistence and do a quick save to make sure the latest changes to the notebook are saved. It's possible to use the CPU or TPU runtime for more options, such as using models from CivitAI or LoRAs, but the generation time will be much slower. Here is a quick comparison of the three options. Personally, I would stick to the GPU runtime and just use the default base and refiner models. Lastly, I'll quickly show how the app works on a Colab Pro tier. I'm not trying to pitch Colab Pro here, but if you already have access to it, this test run will show how it works for adding models and LoRAs. I use it to run tasks that are outside of my VRAM capacity, or to play with AI apps when I'm away from my PC. One of my favorite features with Stable Diffusion are LoRAs, so let's start up the notebook and try applying one. These require a lot of RAM, so make sure the high RAM feature is turned on. We already have an image without a LoRA, so let's copy the parameters and see how it turns out with a LoRA applied. I'll head over to the Models tab and add a LoRA from CivitAI. There are already many to choose from. Just paste the link to the model location field and click Install. Back in the Text to Image tab, we can now select the LoRA for image generation. If it doesn't show up, try reloading the page. When Stable Diffusion magic is done, we can see the new, improved image. Now let's see how the image would look like with a different model instead of SDXL base. Checkpoint models can be installed the same way as LoRAs, from the Models tab. Once downloaded, we can convert them to a Drive folder so they're readily available in the future. To do this, copy the path to your Google Drive folder from the Collab notebook and paste it into the custom save location field. In the next session, just go to the Import Models tab and copy the path to the Drive folder where you saved the model. The models will be added and ready to use in an instant. Or if you don't have enough drive space, you can always just reinstall them in each run, as Pro gives us enough space for that. With both custom models and LoRAs, you can explore all the wild image styles you can imagine. That's all we have for today. If you ran into any hurdles or have some brilliant prompt secrets up your sleeve, don't hesitate to drop a comment below. Let's collaborate, learn, and grow together. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video. Bye!